Welcome back to Let's Code. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today we're talking about Wasm, and specifically Wasmtime, which just hit 1.0 this week. Now, Wasm has been on my, yes, that's interesting, but we don't really have a use case for it right now, list for quite a while. So I've been waiting for it to kind of mature into a state or find a project for which Wasm is the right solution. So Wasmtime in particular opens up a specific set of solutions or potential solutions. It takes Wasm out of the browser and allows you to run it, say, inside of your Rust program. So as you can see here, if you go to the Wasmtime site, it's a bytecode alliance project. You can install the runtime via this curl command, you know, curl pipe to bash, the classic software installation methodology. You can write some Rust, such as using this print line macro. You have to add the wasm32-wasi target, which is different from the wasm32 unknown unknown target we've used in the past on this channel for things like bevy games. In this case, they choose to use Rust C directly rather than using cargo to compile a single file towards the wasm32 wasi target. And that produces you a little wasm file. You can run that wasm file with wasmtime and it prints out hello world. So we've compiled Rust to wasm and then we've run it. So wasm and wasi and the whole set of standards that comprise what we think of as the general concept of Wasm is large and fairly complicated. So I'm not going to get too deep into it, but it's worth noting that Wasm supports Wasi, which is why we're using the Wasm Wasi target. And they are engaged with the standards process, implementing some of the more future proposals to Wasm or Wasi standards. I think that for us, the most interesting things are the optimizing crane lift code generator, which we could get into at some point, but probably won't get into today. Or the configurability, basically the ability to restrict some amount of resources to a user-defined function that was compiled to Wasm that runs in your program. So 1.0, that's pretty big. Wasmtime is using an alternative versioning scheme from most of the rest of the Rust ecosystem. And due to this little graphic here, you can see that there's been a bunch of people who have been using Wasmtime in production already. This includes Shopify and Fastly. I do wonder if this is the primary runtime that Fastly uses to power their edge functions, but we can also see companies like Embark, who have been using Wasmtime as an embedded runtime inside of their game engine. Now, Embark is super interesting to me because they're a huge proponent of open source in general. Embark is roughly what you can think of as like a game studio. One of their most interesting open source projects to me is Rust GPU. We've been doing a lot of shaders on this channel. And Rust GPU is one of the projects that's looking to improve our ability to author shaders with better ergonomics, or in this case, enable the ability to write shaders in Rust instead of using WGSL, which theoretically would allow us to do things like package up Rust crates and ship things like different lighting approaches or a Fresnel effect or some new material that you wanted to use as a crate. And then just install that whenever you wanted it. Right now, the way that we have to do that in Bevy is by shipping snippets of WGSL as text files that you then load in, which is fine, but it's not the most ergonomic and it's not the most fun way to interact with shader code. The other thing I'll mention about Embark is that they support quite a few different Rust projects. So super happy to see them involved here because it makes me feel like they are actually using this and they're actually here to support it. And also it would be really interesting to see Wasmtime linked with Bevy. So maybe we'll see if we can do that at some point. So they start off the like, why would you want to use a WebAssembly runtime at all? With like, hey, Wasm was created for the browser, but it's great outside the browser too. And from my understanding, the browser use case versus the external use case, or like the container-ish use case, is a point of contention in the standards committees. So to be clear, we're going to be talking just about kind of the external containerizable-ish use cases for Wasm, because Wasmtime, as I understand it, would not run in the browser, or you wouldn't ship it to a browser. So you could use Wasmtime to ship or let people ship Wasm-based serverless functions or something like that. People often have strong feelings about serverless function cold starts and things like Firecracker or things like this Wasm runtime, for example, can start up significantly faster. And they're claiming it starts faster than a single JavaScript isolate, which is a V8 isolate, which is really interesting. So that's 5 milliseconds versus 5 microseconds for Wasm time. And of course, because this is a lightweight kind of isolation tool, you can run large multi-tenant platforms with this technology. Another use case they bring up is third-party plugin systems, which is kind of funny to me because the way that this is solved in, say, like the JavaScript ecosystem is it's not. So you can just kind of download any code. It can run whatever it wants to. It can modify anything it wants to. And then good luck, which is not far off from, to be fair, the thing that you're doing when you install some random crate or npm package or whatever. It's just that this is the state of the world currently. People really don't do like third-party like security work for things like a Next plugin or a Gatsby plugin or like something like that, or a Vite plugin, you know? So they're offering up Wasmtime as one of the ways that you can run untrusted code. So you could theoretically let people write their own plugins and then run that on a server somewhere and not have to worry about it. And the rest of the use cases they give are kind of like derivatives of that. Like, hey, you could write embedded functions or stored procedures or something like that, like you would find in MySQL or Postgres or whatever. And you could let people write them in Wasm and then run them in Wasmtime inside of your database, which is kind of the same thing as like the serverless functions use case. If you, for some reason, don't trust your operating system, I don't quite understand what this use case would be. I don't know what the space is for I'm going to run some code, but I'm not going to trust the thing that it's running on. So I don't know. Maybe somebody has a usage of that in the comments that they can share. The other thing they're saying is, hey, portable clients, which like, okay, yes, if it runs Wasmtime and Wasmtime can run on any platform, then you can theoretically run your client code on any platform. So it's kind of the shared libraries approach. So like if you compile to Wasm, then you can use that Wasm inside of a bunch of different environments. And if you also use the Wasmtime runtime, then that Wasm will execute the same way in all of them. They also talk a little bit here about how they make Wasmtime what they call super fast. Basically, I'm just thankful they didn't call it blazing fast because I'm really tired of that phrase. They cover two different areas. They cover instantiation speed, so like cold start, and they cover the actual runtime speed. So like after you've loaded in all the code, like how fast does that code run compared to how fast it would run in your, say, language of choice. Now, I'm not a security engineer, so what I will say is that they talk about security here, but I don't feel qualified to actually cover their security stance here or their security posture. So I will point you to their best practices and the things that other people have said on the topic. But I would say if you're looking to encapsulate programs, that basically the approaches in my mind are either use Firecracker, which is what AWS uses for serverless functions or Lambda, or apparently, hopefully, you could also use Wasmtime for that use case. And finally, they kind of cut it off with they've shipped 1.0 and now they're going to ship every month and they will bump the major version number every month, which is a really kind of strange release numbering scheme, if only because I'm very used to seeing Semver everywhere and very used to everybody being like, oh, everything's going to be 0.whatever for the rest of its life, until some project like React or something realizes they've gone 0.whatever for too long and now it's version 15 instead of 0.15. So it's interesting. They claim that they're doing this to make sure that they can keep the Wasmtime version number in sync with all of the runtime like wrapper version numbers. So there's a Wasmtime embedding for Python and for Rust and for C and for a whole bunch of other languages, right? If we go back to the actual Wasmtime site and I make this a little bigger, you can see that they've got the Rust crate, which is the Wasmtime crate. The project is written in Rust, so it's not surprising to see that. There's a C crate, there's a C++, or not a C crate, there's, I guess, C header files and assorted source files that you can go use. There's C++ files that you can also use, or there's a Wasmtime package or repository for Python.NET and Go. Which leaves us at the Wasmtime guide, which I think I'll leave for another video because this is just kind of a video to say, hey, Wasmtime hit 1.0. It may be, if you are waiting for Wasm to have a use case, it may be time for you to take a look at a project that just hit 1.0 and see if it fills a need that you have. For me, I think the things that I'm interested in the most are potentially using it as a scripting target for bevy games. it would be really cool if we could find a way to kind of embed Wasmtime inside of the Bevy sort of life cycle in a way and let people interact with an exposed API. The modding story in Bevy specifically is not settled yet. It's one of those things that kind of like some people have done some things and we haven't quite figured out what the solution or official recommendation or anything like that is going to be. So interested to see if Wasmtime could do anything for modding support in Bevy games. And the other Wasm approach or Wasm use case that I'm looking at personally is doing some image manipulation in the browser or anything that would render to canvas. So we've been doing a lot of shaders, we've been doing a lot of GPU stuff. And if we use WGPU as we've been using it, we've already seen that that can compile into a browser. So can we build interesting things just with WGPU in the browser as part of a larger application? And I guess we'll find out. So I'll catch you in the next video, and I hope you enjoyed this one. See ya.